You are about to listen to Mental Health and High Sensitivity, written by Manuela Pérez Chacón, Antonio Chacón, and Juan Moses de la Serna. Copyright 2021. Juan Moses de la Serna, Ediciones Tech Time. Narrated by Ian A. Miller and published by Tech Time. Chapter 1. Introduction to the study of the relationship between high sensitivity and mental health. Whether you are a highly sensitive person or a mental health professional, you will benefit from reading this book. You may be a person who has discovered your highly sensitive trait as a result of not feeling too good about yourself. Or maybe you have spent years going to psychologists and psychiatrists, or have been looking for information until someone enlightened you with knowledge of the existence of highly sensitive people, HSP. You may be a professional who has cared for people you could not quite manage to understand, people who did not exactly have a disorder, but there was something that prevented them from growing and continuing their journey in life with ease. Perhaps your case is that of an individual who is having a hard time communicating with their partner because it seems that you are each speaking a different language, since each one feels and perceives the world differently. You may have even left a job due to feeling like you did not fit in, whether with others or with repetitive and routine tasks. We all indeed have sensitivity, and it is also true that anyone may need at some point in their life to go to a psychology professional to resolve something, whether small or big. This book aims to provide a way to work with highly sensitive people. What is written here will help you not only to identify the trait, but also to detect the psychological consequences of it from a psychology professional point of view. It addresses high sensitivity, HS, or sensory processing sensitivity, SPS, as seen by mental health experts, a contribution of experiences, studies, and scientific basis. We will define what it means to be a highly sensitive person, and your relationship with your environment from the strictest sense of the word. By reading this book, you will learn about the most common psychological disorders and why highly sensitive people can suffer from them. You will understand the talent and the high capacity that highly sensitive people possess. All this is explained from a psychological point of view. No doubt the experiences of highly sensitive people serve as an example to us. However, we want to raise awareness among the HSP and HSC population of the importance of putting themselves in the hands of health professionals. It is the psychologists, counselors, pediatricians, and psychiatrists trained in high sensitivity who are the most adept at solving the problems you may encounter. It is essential to keep in mind that being highly sensitive is not the same as having a disorder. There are specific treatments currently being developed by scientific researchers. Possessing the trait of high sensitivity can lead you to suffer certain difficulties, but also benefit from many advantages. The detection and diagnosis of any disorder associated with the trait should be left in the hands of mental health experts. It is just as important to know who to turn to so you can find solutions if you possess the highly sensitive trait and questions arise, as well as to know that anyone around you can be an HSP. It is also essential to trust the sciences, and psychology is one of them. Psychological techniques and treatments are a result of experiments and research that have been carried out by numerous experts over the years. In this book, we aim to make a connection between this scientific precision and the personality trait that we now colloquially know as high sensitivity. The scientific name for this trait corresponds to sensory processing sensitivity. The highly sensitive person has a way of perceiving and feeling that starts from birth and which is molded through experiences. It is a type of personality that includes a high capacity to process information about your surroundings. It makes you more aware of everything that enters through the five senses, especially in new or unexpected situations. The theory of positive disintegration, known to many as a theory of emotional development, by the Polish psychologist and psychiatrist Dabrowski during the beginning of psychology as a science, classified this ability as part of the different levels of human development. This book will provide you with both information and possible solutions. If you are someone who is involved in caring for the emotional needs of a person, whether that person is your child, your student, or your patient. In this book, you will find key information not found in other books, since it explains the relationship between high sensitivity and its possible consequences on an individual throughout their life. In addition to delivering a practical approach that can help highly sensitive people to manage their trait or help a person learn how to interact with highly sensitive children, this book provides data and sample consultations, as well as the most recent research on high sensitivity. This book is the result of a collaboration between high sensitivity professionals and has been written in the form of a research project. It provides information collected from group therapies and individual psychology sessions conducted over several years in mental health departments and addresses some central issues of the daily work of highly sensitive professionals with children and adolescents. Care of children is a field of great concern regarding study and treatment, especially in the interests of the prevention of possible mental disorders. Young people are the human potential of the near future in companies. We have focused on the symptoms that derive from the presence of the highly sensitive trait in an individual under the perspective of the diagnostic axes of the Diagnostic and Statistical Manual of Mental Disorders, DSM-5. Risk factors, current treatments, and prevention have been based on cognitive behavioral therapies. The diagnosis and evaluation provide a comparison and bring to light the possible confusion with some disorders that have similar pathological signs. Regarding the research models described, they include scientific theories at an international level that have been instrumental in the discovery of the high sensitivity trait. At present, there is a lot of research that supports the existence of this particular trait in a portion of the world's population. Several scientists from different countries have provided contrasting data on this particular way of feeling, thinking, and acting. Up until now, science has shown us through studies conducted that approximately 20% of the population has high sensitivity. Aron and Aron, 1997. These are people with the innate ability to observe the smallest details, and they do so unconsciously. They also need more rest time, as they are easily overstimulated and must learn to manage their emotions in the face of excessive noise or crowded places. They show strong emotional responses and sometimes require more downtime. Likewise, the authors affirm that of this percentage of people who possess the trait of high sensitivity, 70% are introverts. The development of the highly sensitive child scale and identification of sensitivity groups by Plus in 2017, published in Developmental Psychology, is also a statistical study. The development of the highly sensitive child scale and identification of sensitivity groups, Plus 2017, published in Developmental Psychology, is also a statistical study. Among its results is the existence of three different groups with different levels of environmental sensitivity. It indicates that all living beings must be sensitive to their surroundings and classifies 25-35% as highly sensitive, 41-47% as intermediate, and 25-35% as low. The highly sensitive person presents characteristics from birth that accompany them throughout their lives. These characteristics affect their well-being and, as a result, their mental health. Elaine Aron, a pioneer research psychologist in the United States, highlighted the following peculiarities of HSP people. They can unconsciously show a heightened awareness of and strong reaction when encountering stimuli in their surroundings, even when these are subtle. This intense emotional reaction is just because everything, both positive and negative, affects the HSP more. They also experience high levels of arousal due to sensory stimulation to noises, smells, and other sensations. A high capacity for empathy and increased sensory sensitivity to stimuli, which is manifested by a heightened ability to differentiate sensations, is also found in the HSP. The highly sensitive person and highly sensitive children are individuals who come by these personality traits naturally. They could focus these traits toward a positive outcome, avoiding a negative path, provided they have an awareness of their uniqueness and the proper tools to cope with the difficulties that may arise along the way, as well as knowledge of how to enhance their strengths. They are people with a gift because of their great creativity and their ability to process information. But they are also people who can easily become stressed or who tend to avoid certain social situations. Hence, the importance of knowing whether or not you are a highly sensitive person or whether or not your child is a highly sensitive child. The highly sensitive person can be identified by the high levels of sensitivity he or she exhibits. These are people who are easily excited by the stimuli around them. Other characteristics to take into account are empathy and the ability to grasp information from their surroundings. Those who possess the trait of high sensitivity process information in a peculiar way. They analyze everything more thoroughly. They can understand how the other person feels and take the emotions they perceive to the extreme. Therefore, when day-to-day emotions are positive, joy, calmness, optimism, etc., the HSP can control what he or she feels to his or her benefit. In this case, it is an advantage to be a highly sensitive person. Although, since it is a genetic trait, it's not something you can choose to be. You are simply born or not born with the trait of high sensitivity. On the other hand, when a person is faced with a complex routine full of negative emotions, anger, sadness, anguish, etc., psychological problems may appear. It is common to encounter difficult situations throughout life. That's what living is all about, having all kinds of experiences and learning how to deal with them. However, for the highly sensitive person, it is often difficult to make decisions because of emotional factors that are difficult to control. The most common difficulties that arise after mismanagement of high sensitivity are low self-esteem, anxiety, stress, phobias, depression, and even borderline personality disorder. Some of the symptoms that indicate the need to seek professional help are insomnia, muscular pain, low mood, emotional tension, anger, etc. In children, symptoms such as insecurity, shyness, attention deficit, and irritability stand out. That is not to say that highly sensitive people are more likely to experience psychological symptoms just because they were born with the trait of high sensitivity. We want to say that perhaps having greater sensitivity to stimuli may increase the activation of the person in general. That is, if a highly sensitive person has many experiences that generate extreme or negative emotions, he or she is exposing him or herself to more pressure. Their body is stressed by situations that may go unnoticed by people who are not highly sensitive. It is also possible that the sum of stressful experiences may cause physical symptoms in the highly sensitive person that would not even affect anyone else. The brain of the highly sensitive person pays more attention to sensations in his body that could be considered insignificant, whereas other people do not perceive these sensations. It remains to be seen whether highly sensitive people go to the doctor more because of problems or complaints that cannot be diagnosed as a specific disease. One thing we do know is that highly sensitive people become more saturated with less stimulation than other people. Their sensory threshold is lower. That is, they are more affected by stimuli and therefore are more easily overexcited or overstimulated. No one works well under pressure or under the effects of overstimulation, nor do we all perform equally well at work or school when faced with tasks that involve too much emotional stress. It is therefore imperative for the highly sensitive person to learn to manage this intense influx of information when it causes problems in their routine. This will allow them to carry out daily tasks with peace of mind and naturalness. The solution should not be to refuse activities, but rather to get to know oneself well and develop psychological strategies. Social skills can also be learned or encouraged. It is especially important to do a self-assessment in line with one's own emotions. The emotional reaction of a highly sensitive person is more extreme or notable than that of any other person, even in the same situation. For example, two brothers of similar age are watching a dramatic movie. One of them cries.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.